Hello. Hey. I've never said if you just shout, it usually gets people talking a little bit louder. It's a pretty quiet room. It's okay. Something different. Sounds different. Everybody doing okay? Thank you so much for coming out. This is awesome. Is everyone coming to the show tomorrow?
Yeah.
All right.
Hi.
How are you coming?
Nice.
What number is this? Do you know?
I actually don't. I think seven.
Seven?
Yeah.
Holy
shit. It's the third one at the Cultural Center.
Okay.
So there's like three before the Leonard one. Yeah, I think it's the seventh one.
Kaiser Valley
is the first one.
Where was Kaiser Valley? Oh, yeah.
Community Center, where we just set up some tables and got a couple kegs.
That was a disaster.
Yeah, it was a disaster.
The big disaster was the venue one, yeah. Where they let people in early and then people couldn't get in.
Oh, yeah, it was a nightmare.
Yeah. It was fun, but it was
great.
To me, it was
church in South Grant.
Yep, that's where my sister had her wedding reception.
We have one there?
Yeah, St. Mary's Center.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh no, I was thinking of the one by the banana factory.
The family's banana factory. That was the one by the VA hospital.
What was the name of that place?
The banana factory. Thank you. The banana factory.
Yeah, they make bananas. Yeah.
You know that big building, the Victorian looking one, that when you cross the 7th Street Bridge from West Side to downtown?
Yep.
The Abdallah building, that was my mom's maiden name is Abdallah, that was our banana factory. Manufactured bananas.
Big assembly line in there.
The first holiday show though at the Kaiser Community Center, I gave them twice the rent because it was so dirty and messed up, and they never called me after. They never said anything, so I think it worked out all well.
Yeah, we're like, all right, we won't
like,
talk about this ever again.
Dogs lie.
Yeah. So, thanks again for coming out. Thanks, Tiger
thanks
Shaw.
So much.
Alt 92.1 for having us.
Yeah.
What's that?
I was just gonna make a joke about how it sounds different.
I thought that I read the radio station wrong, but I was like, I was reading it off the wall. So they're gonna be like, that's not what it's called. This song's called Bad Catholics. 1, 2, 3. Get stoned and drive around with just a half a pack of smokes, bottle of clear eyes and appetite. We were pilching the Turkey Hill on Main Avenue West Side. Wouldn't you guess the only thing we had to fear would be flashing the lights in a real blue mirror. This time they got us, it's all over now. You were praying Hail Marys for an escape route. Both of us know. your secret. Yeah, I know your secret. Bad Catholics sworn we are always dipping up before communion started. Bad Catholics sworn we are always dipping up before communion started. Bad Catholics sworn we are always dipping up before communion started. Bad Catholics sworn we
Somebody forget to pay the light bill.
What's that?
Did they forget to pay the light bill?
Yeah, I think so.
You went to Catholic school, huh, Tom?
I did. I went to Catholic school for 2 years. I went to Bishop O'Hara.
How was it?
It fucking sucked. It's the worst 2 years of my life. God. I still am trying to reconcile that with my parents, you know?
Because it was the best 2 years of their life.
This is probably the best 2 years of their life, yeah. My brothers and sisters went there and they had a good time somehow.
Somehow.
It was the fucking worst. I just hung out with all the Jewish kids and the kids from Lake Ariel, two of them.
Oh, yeah?
Like, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I went to a Catholic middle school, which is fine because you're young and it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, you don't have like, you know, you don't have like a worldview that
no,
you
really yeah.
shape at that point.
Yeah. What's up with this light, seriously? I could Venmo you some money if you need it.
Hey, thanks.
There we go.
I've been having a horrible time pulling myself together. I've been closing my eyes to find the old familiar failures. I've been having a horrible time pulling myself together.
I saw the knife down, bleeding full.
this year called After the Party. Yeah, it's been an awesome year traveling and being able to play those songs. This is one of the songs off of it. When we first started traveling, the first place that we got any success was in the Midwest. And I think that a lot of it was just of how similar the vibe and the people are to Scranton. And we just kind of identified with the Midwestern lifestyle.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, and this is a song about the Midwest and feeling at home there. The song's called Midwestern States. How would we do this one?
Just wing it.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, da na na na.
Yeah, that sounds great.
1, 2, 3, 4. I hope this isn't a burden. Well, thanks for having us over. We could sleep on the couch, we could sleep on the floor. We would leave before you even noticed we were here, even notice us at all. Been having problems with our landlord. He said he's taking us both to court. She got her hours slashed and my unemployment's drying up fast. We both got worthless diplomas from worthless universities. Two bachelors in worthless studies, but at least it made our parents happy and cost a whole lot of money. You said, days if we drive straight, Denver if we get tired, said you didn't mind stopping just as long as we got out of the Midwest states, the Western states, the Midwestern states, the Midwestern states, the Midwestern states. But I know somewhere in Chicago where we can stay for a little. I hope this isn't a burden. Yeah, thanks for having us over. Most nights we always fell asleep with something dumb on Netflix. Some nights trash reality or kids' cartoons or shitty documentaries. Not perfect, but we're good together. Yeah, me, you, and our bad tattoos. Yeah, all our stick and pokes, all our inside jokes. Regret them when we're dead and sober. But we're still breathing, and the party ain't over. You said LA is only 2 days. If we dive straight, then if we get tired, make a confession about my when the Netflix line came up, I made me immediately think of maybe the worst thing I've ever watched on Netflix in my entire life, and I love it. What's the name of the show? Basically, it's an Australian show, which I didn't find out until I started watching it, which made it so much better. Don't ask me why I picked this, but it's basically about couples that are getting married that have no money. So they they get married with, or they try to plan a wedding with like $2,000, and it's great because it's just like they're just bogans. Bogans, and
That was the first type of person that we learned about in Australia were the bogans.
Yeah,
it's basically an Australian redneck, but not like, Well, they're like
they don't always live in the bush.
Yeah,
there's they do, but
they're everywhere.
They're everywhere. Yeah, Adelaide a lot.
They have like a Southern Cross tattoo, and they'll be the loudest person in the room. They drive around utes, which is in Australia they take every word and boil it down to one syllable if possible, and then add a Y at the end. But they drive utes, which is short for a utility vehicle, which is just a truck with a cab and then a flatbed in the back, and they drive around in those.
Yeah, it's amazing.
I don't know what they... Yeah, they're a different breed. They all have, like, you know, obscure tan lines because they're just in the sun all day.
A lot of tribal tattoos.
A lot of tribal tattoos, for sure. Yeah. And they drink mixed drinks out of cans.
They love mixed drinks out of cans. All of the cocktails, they were all mixed drinks. And then one couple got a Slurpee machine, and they're like, well, we can just do Slurpees, and we'll just buy a bunch of vodka, and we'll just do Slurpees. So it's like a bunch of, like, you know, the grandparents, like, drinking just, like,
oh, that's amazing.
whatever the hell it is. Yeah, it's definitely the worst show I've ever seen in my life, but I kind of like watching car accidents sometimes.
You can't turn away.
I know. It's ridiculous.
And they talk funny, so it's got to be like...
Oh, yeah. Trash.
Speaking of Australian weddings, now, but this song I wrote for my sisters. One of whom moved away. She's down in Columbia, Maryland. She's a speech pathologist now. She was like the most naive one of all of us, and somehow turned out to be the most like having her shit together. And my other sister is fighting the power company in Jessup. That's her thing.
Woo!
Yeah.
Hate that power company.
Fuck that. Yeah, she put solar panels on her house. She's like, I fucking hate this place. But the song's called Mail Call.
is to you. The same chords that I stole from a song that I once heard. The same melody I borrowed from the void. I rather observe the structured narrative. The characters often, the plot does not develop. It ends where it begins on the screen in paperback. Section 8 in cul-de-sacs. Electro acoustic drum sonnets are moving me along. Along. You cut my hair, you act red. Ink everywhere. Do my hands tell a story?
It's really cool. It's the first time I'm in here. Is this your? Have you been here before?
No, never.
Yeah,
this is downstairs really, one time, but never.
This
here.
Is awesome being in here, and this room is incredible too.
Yeah, Phil told us this used to be a TV studio.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, pretty cool.
Our drummer Joe was in a lot of local commercials growing up.
He was. I wonder if it was filmed in here. Joe, where were you in the flower commercial, Southside Bowl? Yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah. I remember, so Joe's family and my family were really close. His great aunt was best friends with my grandmother. And I knew Tony and Joey were the, Joe and his brother. But I remember when you were on Topper's Clubhouse, it was a big, big fucking deal at the Abdallah house.
Wolfie.
Big deal all around here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what Topper's doing right now. I hope he's doing really well, I gotta say. You found, you're friends with him on Facebook?
Yeah, Scott Topper.
Scott
really?
Topper, all right.
What's he do?
Nothing.
Oh, come on.
No, I'm serious.
Nothing?
Well, he does something.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Hang out Wolfie anymore.
Yeah, oh,
yeah, probably not.
Yeah.
At least it didn't turn into... Remember, like, Steve from Blue's Clues? Did he die or something?
No.
There was a bunch of rumors.
No.
He's a heroin
addict. He started a punk band.
What?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. He started a punk band.
Nice.
He was pretty cool.
Yeah, he was pretty cool.
anybody have any, is there
yeah,
is
anybody have a good Topper drug story or something? He went down.
You see him at Poor Richard's. I like this kind of comedy set that we got going on.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah. Well, it's comedy for us. You guys are probably just like, all right, shut the fuck up. This sucks.
It's a fucking song.
It's nice being able to talk every once in a while. We have three songs left.
I am the pain that beats through your temples every morning when you wake up. I am the boy with alcohol poisoning all the parties Christmas throwing that summer that they took us in. Like every other American, we're getting drunk round back of the Lions Club, waiting for the shitty bands to finish up. Some kids played hacky sack while the others just got fall for a waitress when you both smoke the same cigarettes. You get seated as diners and lovers. You get the check as friends for the better. You call your names into the pub pack list just to read them. And you get old enough to know that happiness is just a moment. I'm marching up to your gates today.
Shit, I'm going to Catholic school before, and I stand by that, but I don't want to disparage anyone in their faith, Christianity and Catholicism. Sometimes there's nothing more annoying than like a hyper-materialist atheist that's just like, God's dead and everybody doesn't think that. It's a fucking idiot. Yeah. Those people are the worst.
It's true. It's true. It's pretty
brutal. Yeah, it's so bad. But there's so many wonderful things that you can get from the philosophies of the theology of Catholicism and Christianity, so take that from it, from what you will.
How was the food?
The
at Catholic school.
Oh God.
Oh, God.
There was French fries. I remember that. Okay. I don't remember. Yeah, the cafeteria of that school was in the basement. That was a pretty shitty place. Yeah, the food was definitely sucked too. Otherwise, I remember it was good. But you could smoke in the bathroom there, and it was harder to smoke in the bathroom at Scranton High School. So they had that going for them. With that. Oh, also, I think it's really funny to mention that I came up with the very end, like the full rap. I was working on the chorus of this song for a while, And I came up with the end part of it when Bethany and I were at the art museum walking down the rocky steps.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that was pretty cool. I wanted to mention that. Especially for how goofy it is. And some guy tried to sell me a t-shirt.
Are you going to say what song it is?
Yeah, it's called House on Fire.
How did I... One, two, three. All right, so we'll do that.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four. Thank you all so much for coming to the show tomorrow, and for everybody that's been coming to the show over the years and everything. It's a really cool thing that we get to do and donate all the money to charity. So thank you for supporting it. There's a lot of awesome bands that come and dedicate their time, and a lot of people that dedicate their sound help and food and staff and security and everything. So it's an awesome thing that we all get to do, to come together. And thank you so much for supporting it year and year.
Thank you.
That's what I'm trying to say. So thank you.
Much gratitude.
Lost in a picture.